Welcome to this comprehensive tutorial on deploying Llama 3.1 using Google Cloud Vertex AI and integrating it with the custom Flask web interface. Whether you're a data scientist, architect, or developer looking to leverage Google's powerful AI infrastructure, this guide will walk you through every step of the process. We'll begin by understanding Vertex AI Model Garden and endpoints before diving into deployment, creating a cloud function, and finally setting up a web interface on Google Cloud Run. Let's start by discussing Vertex AI Model Garden and endpoints. Vertex AI is Google Cloud's fully managed AI platform that simplifies building, deploying, and scaling machine learning models. The Model Garden is a carefully selected collection of pre-trained models from Google's research and other sources. These models are optimized and ready to be deployed to Vertex AI endpoints. Endpoints in Vertex AI are fully managed and scalable, allowing you to serve predictions from your models. By using these endpoints, you can quickly integrate your models into applications without worrying about infrastructure management. Now that we understand the basics, let's move on to deploying the Llama 3.1 Instruct 8 billion model using the Vertex console. We'll start by navigating to the Llama 3.1 model card, where you'll see the option to deploy. We'll use the one-click deploy feature. On the configuration page, you'll need to specify the resource ID, model name, and endpoint name that will be used to call this model. You'll also need to specify the region and machine specifications required for deployment. For this tutorial, we'll use the G2 standard 12 machine type with an NVIDIA L4 TPU accelerator, which is designed specifically for AI tasks, and set the accelerator count to 1. The deployment process takes a few minutes, so I've already taken care of that step for us. Before moving along, though, let's take a moment to explore the model registry. This is where all your deployed or soon-to-be-deployed models are stored. The model registry is more than just storage. It's a command center where you can manage, version, and update your models. Once our model is deployed, we'll head to the Online Predictions section in Vertex AI. Here, we can see the endpoint where our model is deployed. We can use the Online Prediction feature to send requests to our model directly from the Vertex AI console. If we open up the endpoint, we can see the settings and metrics for the model. We can also find sample requests under the API section, which shows us how to send requests to the model endpoint. There are examples for both REST APIs and Python. For this tutorial, we'll use the Python example to create a Google Cloud function. Now that we have our model deployed and accessible via an endpoint, our next step is to create a Google Cloud function. This function will act as an intermediary between our web interface and the Vertex AI endpoint. Cloud functions are serverless compute services that allow you to execute code in response to events without managing any servers. To create our cloud function, we'll navigate to the Google Cloud console and search for Cloud Functions. Click on Create Function to begin. We'll need to set some basic configurations, the function name, the region, allowing unauthenticated invocations, CPU, and memory allocations, and a minimum number of instances to avoid cold starts. After setting these configurations, we'll click Next to access the inline editor. Here, we'll write our cloud function code. The function we're creating will do several important things. Initialize the Google Cloud AI Platform client, process incoming requests, ensuring they include the necessary data, send the data to the Llama 3.1 Vertex AI endpoint and receive its predictions, and return the predictions in a JSON format. Let's break down the key components of our cloud function. First, we have a helper function called convert protobuf to dict. This function converts protobuf objects to dictionaries, making the response more manageable. Next, we have the predict custom train model sample function. This is where the actual prediction request is made to the endpoint. We configure the client, prepare the request, and send it to the specific endpoint. Finally, we have the main predict function. This is the entry point for our cloud function, decorated with @functionsframework.http. It handles HTTP requests to our cloud function, processes the request, invokes the prediction function, and returns the result. In our code, we'll need to specify our project ID and the endpoint ID where our model is deployed. Make sure to replace these with your actual project and endpoint IDs. Once our code is ready, we'll select Python 3.11 as our runtime, paste the code into the inline editor, and set the entry point as predict. Then we'll click deploy to make our function available at a specific URL. With our cloud function deployed, we now have a serverless way to interact with the Llama 3.1 model. To ensure our cloud function is working as expected, we can use a tool like Postman to test it. We'll create a new post request in Postman, enter the URL of our deployed cloud function, and in the body of the request, we'll enter a JSON object with the prompt we want to send to the model. When we send the request, we should receive a response from the Llama 3.1 model with generated text, confirming that our cloud function is correctly interfacing with the Vertex AI endpoint. Now that we have our cloud function up and running, we're ready to move on to the next exciting step: creating a web interface using Flask and deploying it on Google Cloud Run. This will allow users to interact with our Llama 3.1 model through a simple, user-friendly interface. Flask is a lightweight web application framework in Python, perfect for our needs. We'll use it to create a simple web interface that allows users to input prompts and receive responses from our Llama 3.1 model. Google Cloud Run is a fully managed platform that will automatically scale our containerized application, handling the infrastructure for us. Let's start by looking at the code for our Flask application. We'll create two main files, an HTML template for the web interface and a Python file for the Flask application itself. First, let's examine the HTML file. This will be a simple form where users can enter their prompts and submit them to the Flask application. The HTML file contains a form element with a text input for the prompt and a submit button. When submitted, this form will send a post request to a Flask root called /predict. Now let's look at the Flask application itself. We import Flask and create an instance of the application. Then we define the URL of our deployed cloud function. This is the same URL we tested in Postman earlier. We create a root called /predict that handles post requests from the form. Within this root, we make a post request to our deployed cloud function, sending the user's input as a prompt. Finally, we render the results on a web page, displaying the output generated by the Llama 3.1 model. With our Flask application ready, the next step is to containerize it using Docker. This will allow us to deploy it easily on Google Cloud Run. Here's a brief overview of our Docker file. We start with the base image of Python 3.11 Slim. We copy our application code into the container, we install the required Python packages, and we use the cmd command to run our Flask application. Now that our container image is ready, we can deploy it to Cloud Run. Navigate to Google Cloud Run and the Google Cloud Console. Click on Create Service. We'll connect our GitHub repository where our Flask application code is stored. This allows us to set up continuous integration and build deployment using Cloud Build. Select Google Cloud Build as our build method and choose GitHub as our repository provider. Next up, find and select our Llama 3.1 Flask application repository. We'll use the Docker file we created earlier, which should be located in the root directory of our repository. Allow unauthenticated invocations for testing purposes, and set the minimum number of instances to 1. Under container settings, we'll allocate 2 gigabytes of memory and 1 CPU. After the deployment is complete, our Flask application will be live, allowing users to interact with the Llama 3.1 model via the web interface. To test that everything is working correctly, we'll use the public URL provided by the Cloud Run service. Here we can enter a simple prompt and click Submit. The output generated by the Llama 3.1 model should then be displayed on the page. This same process can be used to deploy larger models, such as a 70B base model or Instruct model, following the same steps we've outlined here. Also note that by enabling public access, bad actors could potentially overload our service, leading to availability and cost issues. Consider securing both the Flask app and the Cloud Functions endpoint as you transition to more production-grade usage. Anyway, with that, we want to thank you very much for watching and encourage you to ask any questions in the comment section. If you'd like to support the channel, get a free trial of our new design tool linked in the video description, and let us know what you think. Have a wonderful day, and please enjoy responsibly.